I, for a few years, have been running a lab called the Control Optimization Lab, COOL for an abbreviation. It focuses on optimal control theory and its application to problems such as energy storage and management, including management of electrochemical batteries.
Currently, I am working on the identification of entropy coefficients for lithium-ion phosphate batteries. Entropy coefficients are a measurement of the deviation of the battery open circuit voltage as the temperature changes. You know, where these entropy coefficients are useful is to determine how much reversible heat is being generated within the battery. So how much will the battery spontaneously heat up or cool down?
There is a need for algorithms for determining the thermal parameters that govern the thermal behavior of batteries efficiently from short experiments. There's also a need for algorithms for controlling the temperature of a battery in an intelligent manner.
We are not just running experiments. The experiments that we have are, we design them in an optimal way to get the results, you know, the most accurate results, and also in the shortest time as possible.
One of the projects that I've been working on recently has to do with estimating the capacity of cells inside a vehicle battery pack. In some ways, the performance of a vehicle battery pack tends to be dependent on the weakest member.
In a battery pack, you don't want to necessarily invest all the time and energy and resources into determining the correct parameters and the correct state of charge and correct state of health of every single battery cell in a pack. There may be thousands of cells in a pack.
So cells in a battery pack that have capacity which is significantly different from the average capacity in the battery pack may show up as outliers. And so one of the things that I'm working on right now is figuring out a way of detecting those outliers.
Instead of working with batteries, now I'm working with airborne wind energy systems. So what that is if you take a normal turbine, it's connected to the ground via a tower, and those towers can only reach a certain height. So what people started doing is they started getting rid of the towers and using tethers. It can reach higher altitudes where there's higher wind density.
There is an opportunity for airborne wind power generation to truly benefit from crosswind flight, where these airborne wind turbines fly, you know, crosswind across the incoming wind to increase the apparent wind speed and therefore increase wind power generation.
So I've been looking at how to optimize the trajectories of these airborne wind turbines, just trying to get the most wind energy out of them.
Our focus is not so much on the fundamentals of optimal control theory, although we do contribute to the fundamentals. It is on the use of optimal control theory to hopefully make the world a better place by studying problems of significant practical impact like renewable energy generation, energy storage, the health management of energy storage systems, etc. One of the biggest challenges with electrochemical batteries is their behavior is affected by temperature.
If we had this knowledge about entropy coefficients, we can design better temperature controllers for batteries. Why? Because we will have a better understanding of how the battery, you know, is cooling or is warming up. So you wouldn't have to be as conservative and your batteries would not have to be as over-designed.
The outlier detection work will provide other members of the lab with the information that they need in order to do model-based optimal control of vehicle battery packs in an intelligent fashion. The hope is that an intelligently controlled battery pack will lead to better usage of the battery capacity that's already available inside a pack. This would prolong lifespans of electric vehicles and basically lower costs, and that should lead to better adoption of electric vehicles.